Hello, malt mates and motorcyclists. Ralfy here, part 5 of my ongoing mini vlog series. Not about whiskey, which is what I usually review, but I'm on location, you see, for another reason. I'm at Bonneville 2016 Speed Week, world famous event where vehicles of all styles and shapes and sizes and characters and personalities come to go as fast as they can. And do you know what, malt mates? And motorcyclists, some of them even set new world records. I'm attempting to do that. At the moment, I'm struggling. I tell you what does help, these wonderful shades. They cut out the blue light spectrum and they stop the dazzle, extreme dazzle, that you can get from the reflection of the heat sunlight on the white salt surface. But you're more used to seeing me like this. So I'll put them away for the moment. And I've had a bit of a disaster. My last mini vlog, I think number 4, showed me going off the line and having a reasonably faltered but successful run down the salt in the rookie line, the short course 3 miles, where you get counted, time counted between the first and the second mile. All good, nice course, enjoying myself. And then my engineer suggested, well, tell you what, try and avoid top gear because there seems to be a problem with your fuel reservoir. So I'm revving that a little bit harder and pop, I burst my exhaust valve and it rattled about, breaking up my piston. So one of my engines is wrecked. However, I have 3 engines, haha. Cunning master plan, sort of. So we've spent all day removing one engine, putting in the second engine to find it had its own problem. So we've looked at our third engine, we've taken the best part of the third engine, put it with the best part of the second engine, and we've got a good engine as a result of it. The problem seems to be partly mixing new components with old components, an old engine. It sounds reasonable, but in practice it doesn't quite work out as straightforward. Secondly, the heat is playing havoc with old engines. They're delicate, they're sensitive in their own way, although they're quite tough and hardy. But the heat in the afternoon was absolutely playing havoc with the bike. The morning runs, when it's like this, nice and cool, not so bad. But in the afternoon, when it's over 100 degrees, not nice. Not comfortable for me, even with my sexy white motorcycle racing suit and helmet. I think you've probably noticed by now, malt mates. But I'm really enjoying myself. I've really got to thank Richard and John. John's my crew chief and Richard's my engineer. I'll be introducing Richard tomorrow. My next review, where we talk about the bike and show you more about my bike, my 250 vintage pushrod machine, and we'll tell you a bit about that because I know some of you are curious. But in the meantime, I'm going to finish this little vlog by showing you the setting sun as it descends over Bonneville salt flats. The day has ended, the cool of the night appears and mingles in the calming air as the maddening sound of humans and engines departs the salt flats and leaves naught but the ghosts of memories, failures and successes from the heat of the day. Did that sound poetic? Yeah, it did, didn't it?